New research from San Diego State University's Center for Health Economics and Policy Studies estimates that more than 260,000 COVID-19 cases diagnosed in the United States since August 2 can be traced to the Sturgis Motorcycle Rally in South Dakota. The infections come at a public health cost of more than $12.2 billion, according to the research. Andrew Friedson, one of the authors of the paper and an economics professor at the University of Colorado, told Insider that the rally's length, density, and location were the perfect storm for COVID-19 spread. "I was surprised how big this," Friedson said of the estimated spread. "If you look at the month between August 2 and September 2, based on our estimates, Sturgis is responsible for 19% of the cases in the United States. From August 7 to 16, around 350,000 people from around the U.S. flocked to the small city of Sturgis, South Dakota for its annual motorcycle rally. The men and women visited bars and restaurants, attended concerts, and, for the most part, lived life like the coronavirus pandemic didn't exist. After the rally, they went back to their home states, some of them bringing new COVID-19 infections with them." Researchers tracked the spread of COVID-19 after the Sturgis rally. Center for Health Economics and Policy Studies at San Diego State University researchers used anonymized cell phone data to track where Sturgis rally-goers had come from, where they had spent their time, and where they returned to between August 2 and September 2, according to the paper, published by the IZA Institute of Labor Economics. Rather than using contact tracing, the researchers compared counties that had similar demographics and had been seeing similar trends of COVID-19 spread prior to the rally. Then they modeled how the coronavirus spread patterns changed in the weeks following the Sturgis rally. Counties with the highest number of Sturgis attendees based on cell phone data saw COVID-19 cases rise by 10.7% relative to similar counties without attendees, according to the model. By applying that percentage to other counties that had a large number of Sturgis attendees, they arrived at an estimate of 266,796 cases linked to the rally after adjusting for each county's population and pre-rally COVID-19 case count. The figures are a significant slice of the country's overall cases, which stand at more than 6.3 million, according to Johns Hopkins University. The research paper didn't make an estimate for COVID-19 deaths traced back to the rally. The research is awaiting peer review. The thing about this is that most of the cases that we're estimating are showing up in places that are not South Dakota, Friedson told Insider. So it's a situation where a lot of the economic gain is showing up in one place and a lot of the public health cost shows up other places. Nobody was tearing these Confederate flags down. Jim Urquhart for InsiderThe team estimates that the public health cost of the rally is over $12.